Hello students, how are you? Again, welcome to my class. Now today, we will discuss about one new topic, that is highest common factor. Abbreviation of highest common factor is HCF. First, we will discuss about what is the definition of highest common factor. The highest common factor of two or more number is the largest number that divides the number without leaving any remainder. The highest common factor of two or more number is the largest number that divides the number without leaving any remainder. For explanation of this statement, just I want to give one example to you. Suppose you have two number 15 and 20, okay? And you will find out what is HCF of 15 and 20. As you know very well, we have already discussed what is the prime factorization method. So first, we will discuss about prime factorization of 15 and 20. It is the prime factorization of 15. You know very well, 15 is divisible by 3. 3 5s are 15. 5 is prime number. So, it divides only by itself. 5 divided by 5, you will give 1. Okay? Again, 15 divided by 3, it will give to you 5. Then 5 divided by 5, it will give to you 1. Now we will discuss about prime factorization of 20. You know very well, 20 is even number, and even number is always divisible by 2. 20 divided by 2, you will get 10. 10 is also an even number, so 10 divided by 2, you will get 5. And 5 is prime number, it will divide by only itself. 5 divided by 5, it will give to you 1. Okay, so factor of 15 is 3 into 5, and factor of 20 is 2 into 2 into 5. As you are looking, factor of 20 is 2 into 2 into 5. Okay. This is the factor of 15 and it is the factor of 20. Now, in these two number, that means 15 and 20, which is the common factor? Common factor is 5. So HCF or highest common factor of 15 and 20 is 5. Okay, that means what is the meaning of HCF? HCF means highest common factor of two or more number is the largest number that divides the number without leaving any remainder. Now, HCF is 5. Okay, HCF for these two number is 5. And how will you check your answer is right or wrong? What is the statement? Is the largest number that divides the number without leaving any remainder. Now look here, your first number is 15 and 15 divided by 5. Now look here, 15 divided by 5, you know very well, 5 threes are 15, remainder is 0. Its statement, the number without leaving any remainder. Without leaving any remainder means there are remainder is 0. Okay, अगेन 20 डिवाइडेड बाय 5, नाउ लुक हियर 5 4 जा 20, रिमाइंडर इज 0, दैट मींस HCF ऑफ 15 एंड 20 इज 5. माय डियर स्टूडेंट, नाउ लेट अस वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम योर बुक पेज नंबर 45. योर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड द HCF ऑफ 90 एंड 120. ओके, इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी विल अप्लाई द सेम प्रोसीजर, दैट मींस वी विल अप्लाई द प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड. By the help of prime factorization method, easily we can find out HCF or highest common factor. Now let us we see. First we will take out the prime factorization of 90. You know very well 90 is even number, and all even number is divisible by 2. 90 divided by 2, it will give to you 45. Again, 45. By the help of divisibility test, easily we can find out 45 is divisible by 3. 45 is divisible by 3, then quotient will be 15. Then after 15 is divisible by 3, quotient is 5, and 5 is prime number. So this number is divisible by itself. You will get 1. Okay. In prime factorization of any number, please keep in mind, suppose this is first column and this is second column. In this column, that means this is divisor. In divisor column, you will take only prime number. That means in this column, you will take only prime number. As you are looking 2, 3, 3, 5, this is the prime number. Okay. Now let us we will discuss about prime factorization of 120. 120 is even number, it is divisible by 2, so you will get 60. Again 60 is divisible by 2, you will get 30. Then after 30 is divisible by 2, you will get 15. 15 divided by 3, it will give to you 5, and 5 ones are 5. Okay, then after we will take out the common factor of these two numbers. Now look here, prime factorization of 90 is 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. Okay, prime factorization of 90 is 2 into 3 into 3 into 5, and prime factorization of 120 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Now look here, this is the factor of 90, or this is prime factorization of 90. 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. Okay. And prime factorization of 120 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Okay. Then after we will take out the common factor. Now look here. This is the pair of 2. It is the pair of 2. Now again, it is the pair of 3, and this is the pair of 5. Okay, this is the pair of 2, this is the pair of 3, and this is the pair of 5. So 2, 3 is 6 into 5, it will give to you 30. That means HCF will be 30. HCF is 30 for 90 and 120. This is your required answer for your required question. Your next question is, find the HCF of 60 and 84. Okay, we will apply the same procedure. First we will find out prime factorization of 60 and 84. Look here, this is 60 and 60 is even number. All even numbers are divisible by 2. 60 divided by 2, it will give to you 30. Then after 30 is divisible by 2, you will get 15. Again 15 is divisible by 3, it will give to you 5. And 5 is prime number, it is divisible by itself. Okay, then after 84, 84 is even number and all even numbers are divisible by 2, you will get 42. 42 is even number, is divisible by 2. 21 2 is 42, again 21 is divisible by 3. 3 7 is 21 and 7 1 is 7. This is the prime factorization of 60 and it is the prime factorization of 84. Okay, then after we will take out the common factor. Now look here, prime factorization of 60 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Okay, and prime factorization of 84 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 7. Okay, now look here, this is the prime factorization of 60 and it is the prime factorization of 84. Okay, then after we will take out the common factor. Now this is the pair of 2, again this is pair of 2 and this is pair of 3. So 2 2 is 4, 4 3 is 12. That means highest common factor, highest common factor is 12. Highest common factor is 12 for 60 and 84. Okay, and how will you check this answer is right or wrong? Easily we will check by the help of definition of HCF. If 60 divided by 12, now we can check the answer. If 60 divided by 12, 12 5 is 60, remainder is 0. Okay, again 84 is divisible by 12. In this question 60 is divisible by 12, 12 5 ja 60, remainder is 0. In other number 84 is divisible by 12, 12 7 ja 84, remainder is 0. That means highest common factor of 60 and 84 is 12. Okay, 12 is required answer. My dear student, your next question is, find the HCF of 144 and 198. So first we will find out prime factorization of 144. You know very well 144 is even number and even number is divisible by 2. 2 7 is 14, 2 2 is 4. Again 72 is divisible by 2. You will get 36. 36 is divisible by 2. You will get 18. 18 is divisible by 2. You will get 9, and 9 is divisible by 3. You will get 3. 3 is prime number. It is divisible by itself. 3 1 is 3. Okay. Then after we will find out prime factorization of 198. Look here. 198 is even number. This number is divisible by 2. So you will get 99. I hope that all are familiar with division. You will get 99. Then after 99 is divisible by 3. You will get 33. Again 33 is divisible by 3. You will get 11. And 11 1 ja 11. Okay. This is the prime factorization of 144 and it is the prime factorization of 198. Okay. Then after we will find out what is the common factor. Now 144 you can write 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Okay. And factor of 198 is, now look here, 2 into 3 into 3 into 11. 2 into 3 into 3 into 11. Then after we will take out the common factor. Now look here, as you are looking, it is, this is the pair of 2, this is the pair of 2, it is the pair of 3. Okay, it is the pair of 3. Now look here, this is one important point. This is 2 into 3 into 3 into 11. So you know very well in multiplication procedure. In multiplication procedure, we can change the order of any number. So what will you do? In place of 3, in place of 3, you can write 11, and in place of 11 you can write 3. That means in multiplication we can change the order of any number. That's why multiplication follow the commutative property. As you are looking, prime factorization of 198 is 2 into 3 into 3 into 11. But prime factorization of 198, I wrote here 2 into 11 into 3 into 3. That means in multiplication we change the order of any number. That's why multiplication follow the commutative property. So this is pair of 2. This is pair of 3. Again, this is the pair of 3. Okay. 2, 3 is 6. 6, 3 is 18. 2, 3 is 6. 3 is 18. Okay. So, highest common factor. Highest common factor of these two numbers is 18. Okay. This is your required answer for required question. Now your next question is फाइंड द एचसीएफ ऑफ 16, 18 एंड 22. प्रोसीजर इज सेम. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर वन देयर आर टू नंबर. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर टू वी विल फाइंड आउट एचसीएफ ऑफ मोर देन टू नंबर. दैट मीन्स इन दिस क्वेश्चन हाउ मेनी नंबर्स आर देयर. थ्री नंबर, फर्स्ट सेकेंड एंड थर्ड नंबर. ओके, सो वी विल अप्लाई द सेम प्रोसीजर. फर्स्ट वी विल फाइंड आउट प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ 16, 18 एंड 22. ओके, प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ 16 इज 2 8 जा 16, 2 4 जा 8, 2 2 जा 4 एंड 2 1 जा 2. ओके, देन आफ्टर फैक्टर ऑफ 18 इज, और प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ 18 इज 2 9 जा 18, 3 3 जा 9, 3 1 जा 3. अगेन 22 is even number, always divisible by 2, 11 2 जा 22 and 11 1 जा 11. okay, this is the prime factorization of 16, this is prime factorization of 18 and this is prime factorization of 22. after taking out the prime factorization, easily we can find out which is the common factor. Now look here, 16 is equal to 2 and 2 2 and 2 2 and 2 2. Okay, and 18 is equal to 2 and 2 3 and 2 3. Factor of 22 is, or 2 and 2 11. Okay, this is the prime factorization of 16, prime factorization of 18 and prime factorization of 22. Then after we will take out what is the common factor. Now look here, this is 2 2 2, that means this is the pair of 2, it is the pair of 2, and in other factor there are no pair, only this is the pair of 2, 2 is making the pair. Now in other numbers are not making the pair, other numbers are not making the pair, other numbers are not making the pair, so no need to write. That means this is the pair of 2, so HCF, HCF of 16, 18 and 22 is 2. This is your required answer. Then find the HCF of 66, 88 and 132. We will apply the same procedure. First we will take out the prime factorization of 66. 66 is even number, it is divisible by 2, it will give to you 33. Again 33 is divisible by 3, you will get 11 and 11 manja 11. Okay, again 88 is divisible by 2, it will give to you 44. 44 is divisible by 2, it will give to you 22. Again 22 is divisible by 2, it will give to you 11. 11 is prime number, it is divisible by itself, 11 manja 11. Then after 132, 132 is even number and even number is divisible by 2, you will get 66. 66 is divisible by 2, you will get 33. Again 33 is divisible by 3. 11 threes are 33 and 11 ones are 11. Okay, this is the prime factorization of 66, prime factorization of 88 and prime factorization of 132. Then after we will take out the common factor in these three number. Now let us we discuss 66. 2 into 3 into 11. Okay. Prime factorization of 88 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 11. Again, factor of or prime factorization of 132 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 11. Okay, so look here, this is the pair of 2, this is the pair of 2, this is the pair of 2 and it is the pair of 11. So and there are no other pair. It is the pair of 2, it is the pair of 11 and other number is not making the pair. Other number is not making the pair. So no need to write. 11 2's are 22. 11 2's are 22. Okay. 11 2's are 22. That means HCF. HCF of 66, 88 and 132 is 22. Okay. 22 is required answer for the given question. Find the HCF of 150, 175 and 200. For this question, we will apply the same procedure. First, we will find out prime factorization of 150. Okay. 150 is even number. This number is divisible by 2. So it will give to you 75. Again, 75 is divisible by 3. It will give to you 25. Again, 25 is divisible by 5. It will give to you 5. 5 is prime number. It is divisible by itself. And you will get 1. Okay. Then after prime factorization of 175, this number is divisible by 5. So it will give to you 35. I hope that all are know about the division procedure. 35 is divisible by 5. 5 7 is 35 and 7 is prime number. It is divisible by itself. It will give to you 1. Okay. Then after prime factorization of 200. 200 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 100. 100 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 50. 50 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 25. 5 5s are 25. And this is 5 1s are 5. So this is prime factorization of 150, 175 and 200. Then after we will take out the common factor of these three numbers. Now look here, 150 is equal to 2 into 3 into 5 into 5. 2 into 3 into 5 into 5. Prime factorization of 175 is 5 into 5 into 7. Okay. Prime factorization of 200 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 5. Okay. And now look here. This is 175. Prime factorization of 175 is 5 into 5 into 7. And this is 5 into 5 into 7. Now for arrangement of prime factorization of 175 is, prime factorization of 175 is arranged. That means this is 5 into 5 into 7. Now I wrote here prime factorization of 175 is 7 into 5 into 5. In that condition, we will make the easily pair. Now look here. This is the pair of 5. It is the pair of 5. And it is the pair of 5. That means 5 5 is 25. 5 5 is 25. Therefore, SCF is 25. 25 is highest common factor of 150, 175 and 200. That means highest common factor is 25. This is required answer. My dear student, this is your next question, number 3. Find the greatest number. Find the greatest number that will divide 106, 126 and 148 without leaving any remainder. Find the greatest number that will divide 106, 126 and 148 without leaving any remainder. How will you solve this type of problem? Now look here. There is one word greatest. In more than question, suppose in any statement, find the greatest number, find the maximum number. In that condition, you will find out HCF. That's why HCF means highest common factor. And your question is find the greatest number. Greatest number or highest number, both are same. So in this question, we will find out HCF of solution for this question is, in this question, we will find out HCF of 106, 126, and 148. Okay. Now look here. It is 106. We will apply the same procedure. 106 is even number divisible by 2. 2 5 is 10, 2 3 is 6. Okay. 2 5 is 10 and 2 3 is 6. 53 is even number. It is divisible by itself. 53 1 is 53. Then after, next number is 126. 126 is divisible by 2. 2 6 is 12. 2 3 is 6. 63 is divisible by 3, 3 2 जा 6, 3 1 जा 3, again 3 7 जा 21 and 7 1 जा 7, okay, again 148 is even number, this number is divisible by 2, you will get 74, again 74 is divisible by 37. 37 is prime number. It is divisible by itself. Okay. This is prime factorization of 106, prime factorization of 126, and prime factorization of 148. Then after we will take out the common factor in these three numbers. Now look here. Prime factorization of 106 is 2 into 53. Again, prime factorization of 126 is 2 into 3 into 3 into 7. Prime factorization of 148 is 2 into 2 into 37. Okay. Now, this is the prime factorization of 106, prime factorization of 126, prime factorization of 148. Then after we will take out the common factor. As you are looking, this is the pair of 2. This is the pair of 2. That means, now look here, it is the pair of 2. This is the pair of 2, and other number is not making the pair. Other number is not making the pair. So, highest common factor for these three number is 2. HCF is 2 for these three numbers. 2 is required answer. This is question number 4. There are 3 cylindrical container containing 45 liter, 60 liter and 75 liters of water. Find the capacity of the largest container that can be used to measure water in the 3 cylindrical container by exact number of times. The question is, there are 3 cylindrical containers containing 45 liters, 60 liters and 75 liters of water. Find the capacity of the largest container that can be used to measure water in the 3 cylindrical container by exact number of times. In this question, we will find out HCF. That means, in this question is the capacity of the largest container. The capacity of the largest container. Largest means highest. So, highest means we can find out HCF. Solution for this question is the capacity of largest container. Capacity of largest container will be HCF of 45 liter, 60 liter and 75 liter. Okay. The capacity of largest container is equal to HCF of 45 liter, 60 liter and 75 liters. Now look here, we will apply the same procedure, prime factorization of 45. You know very well, 45 is odd number, and by the help of divisibility test, 45 is divisible by 3. The quotient will be 15. 15 is divisible by 3. It will give to you 5, and 5 ones are 5. Okay. Then after we will find out prime factorization of 60. 60 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 30. Again, 30 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 15. 15 is divisible by 3. It will give to you 5. And 5 is prime number. It is divisible by itself. 5 ones are 5. Okay. Then after we will find out prime factorization of 75. You know very well 75 is divisible by which number? That is 3. 75 is divisible by 3. You will get 25. 25 is divisible by 5. You will get 5. And 5 ones are 5. So this is the prime factorization of 45, 60 and 75. This is prime factorization of 45, 60 and 75. Then after we will take out the common factor. Now look here. We will take out the common factor. Prime factorization of 45 is 3 into 3 into 5. Okay. Prime factorization of 60 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Okay. And prime factorization of 75 is, this is 3 into 5 into 5. 3 into 5 into 5. So we can write 3 into 5 into 5. Okay. This is prime factorization of 45, prime factorization of 60, and prime factorization of 75. Okay. Then after we will take out the common factor. It is the pair of 3. As you are looking, it is the pair of 3. This is the pair of 5. It is pair of 3. It is pair of 5. 3 5s are 15. That means 15 is common factor. Or other words, 15 is highest common factor. Highest common factor in these three numbers is 15. So what is your question? Find the capacity of largest container. Answer will be HCF. HCF of these three numbers is 15. 15 is HCF. So 15 liter is highest capacity or largest capacity of the container. 15 liter is required answer. Now, my dear student, let us, we will discuss about one new topic, that is lowest common multiple. Lowest common multiple. Abbreviation of lowest common multiple is LCM. What is the meaning of LCM? And what is the definition of LCM? Now look here. The lowest common multiple of two or more number is The smallest common multiple of the numbers. The lowest common multiple of two or more number is the smallest common multiple of the number. As you are looking, this is LCM. LCM means lowest common multiple. That means LCM is totally depend on the multiple. LCM is totally depend on the multiple of any number. The lowest common multiple of two or more number is the smallest common multiple of the numbers. Okay? Just I want to give one example to you. Suppose you will find out LCM of 15 and 20. Suppose you will find out LCM of 15 and 20. So what is the procedure? Now look here. This procedure is called division procedure. LCM of 15 and 20 is, this is 15 and this is 20. You know very well, this is 15 and this is 20. And you know very well, 15 is divisible by other number and 20 is divisible by other number. Okay? No problem. First we will take, but keep in mind, in this column you will take only prime number. In this column you will take only prime number. Okay? And you know very well, first prime number is 2. Now look here, this is 2. 15 is not divisible by 2. 15 is not divisible by 2. So I wrote here only 15. Okay? And this is 20. 20 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 10. Okay? Again, this is 15, this is 10. 15 is not divisible by 2, but 10 is divisible by 2. So, as it is, we note down the 15, 10 divided by 2, it will give to you 5. Again, we will apply for other prime number. This is 15 and this is 5. You know very well, 15 and 5 is not divisible by 2. So we can note down other prime number. Suppose this is 3 and 15 is divisible by 3. 15 is divisible by 3, then you will get 5. 15 is divisible by 3, then you will get 5. And 5 is not divisible by 3. So as it is, we can write. Again, this is 5, this is 5. 5 is divisible by 5. 5 1 5, 5 1 5. Okay? Then after we will take out, this is the prime number. So what will you do? We can find out the product of these prime number. We can find out the product of these prime numbers. So LCM of 15 and 20 will be, LCM of 15 and 20 will be 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. 2 to the 4, 4 3 the 12, 12 5 the 60. 2 to the 4, 4 3 the 12, 12 5 the 60. That means 60 is common multiple. That means 60 is common multiple of 15 and 20. That means this is LCM. LCM is 60. And this is your required answer for required question. Answer is LCM is equal to 60. This is your required answer. दिस इज योर क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. फाइंड द एलसीएम ऑफ 36 एंड 45. वी कैन अप्लाई द सेम प्रोसीजर. सॉल्यूशन फॉर द गिवन क्वेश्चन इज एलसीएम ऑफ 36 एंड 45 विल बी LCM of 36 and 45 will be, this is 36 and this is 45. Okay. First we will discuss about 36 is divisible by other number, 45 is divisible by other number. No problem. First we will discuss about which is the first prime number. First prime number is 2. And this is 36. 36 is even number. Even number is divisible by 2. 36 is divisible by 2. Then you will get 18. This is 45. Not divisible by 2. Again, this is 18. 18 is divisible by 2. 2 9s are 18. And this is 45. Again, 9 and 45 is not divisible by 2. 9 and 45 is not divisible by 2. 9 and 45 is divisible by 3. 3 3s are 9. And 45 divided by 3, you will get 15. Okay? Then after 3 and 15 is divisible by 3. 3 1s are 3. 3 5s are 15. Okay. Then after this is 5 is divisible by 5. 5 1s are 5. Okay. Then after what we will do? Now look here. This is the first column. Or in other words, this is the divisor column. For finding LCM of we will find out the product of these prime numbers. So LCM of 36 and 45, LCM of 36 and 45 will be 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. LCM of 36 and 45 will be 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. Okay. Now look here. 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 3s are 36, 36 5s are 180. 36 5s are 180. That means LCM of 36 and 45 is 180. This is your required answer. Find the LCM of 42, 70 and 98. We will find out the LCM of 42, 70 and 98. Now look here. LCM of 42, 70 and 98 will be 42, 70 and 98. You know very well, all these numbers are even number. All these numbers are even number. And even number is divisible by 2. 42 divided by 2, it will give to you 21. 70 divided by 2, it will give to you 35. 98 divisible by 2, it will give to you 49. Okay. Then after, this is 21. This is 35 and this is 49. 21, 35, 49. These three numbers are divisible by different number. No problem. After 2, which is your next prime number? That is 3. 3 7s are 21. 35 is not divisible by 3. 35 is not divisible by 3. So as it is, we can write 49 is not divisible by 3. As it is, we can write again after 3, which is your next prime number is 5. Now look here, this is 7, this is 5. 7 is not divisible by 5. So as it is, we can write here 7, 35 is divisible by 5, then you will get 7, 35 is divisible by 5, quotient is 7, 49 is not divisible by 5, as it is, we can write, okay, then after, this is 7, 7 and 49. These three numbers are divisible by 7. 7 1 ja 7, 7 1 ja 7, 7 7 ja 49. Okay. Then after, this is 1, this is 1, 7 1 ja 7. Then after, we will find out the LCM of 42, 70 and 98 will be. What will you do? We will find out the product of these prime numbers. So, LCM of 42, 70 and 98 will be. LCM of 42, 70 and 98 will be 2 into 3 into 5 into 7 into 7. 2 3 ja 6, 6 5 ja 30, 37 ja 210, 210 into 7, 7 into 0, 0, 7 1 ja 7, 7 2 ja 14. That means 1470. 2 3 ja 6, 6 5 ja 30, 37 ja 210, 210 into 7, it will give to you 1470, or other words 1470. 1470 is LCM of these three numbers. 1470 is LCM. This is the required answer for required question. Find the LCM of 108, 132 and 144. We will apply the same procedure. This is 108, 132 and 144. These three numbers are even number, and even number is divisible by 2. It will give to you 54. 132 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 66. 144 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 72. Okay. Then after, 54 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 27. 66 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 33. 72 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 36. Again, this is 2. 27 is not divisible by 2. We can write here as it is 27. 33 is not divisible by 2. It is 33. But 36 is divisible by 2. So you will get 18. Okay. Then after, again, this is 2. 27 is not divisible by 2. It will give to you only 27. That means 27 we can write as it is. 33 we can write as it is. 18 is divisible by 2. It will give to you 9. Again, this is 3. 3 9 ja 27, 11 3 जा 33, 3 3 जा 9, ओके। देन आफ्टर 3, 9 डिवाइडेड बाय 3 इट विल गिव टू यू 3, 11 इज नॉट डिविजिबल बाय 3, सो एज इट इज वी कैन राइट 3 अपॉन 3 इट विल गिव टू यू 1। अगेन दिस इज 3, 3 1 जा 3, दिस इज 11 इज नॉट डिविजिबल बाय 3 एंड दिस इज 1, ओके। देन आफ्टर दिस इज 11, 11 1 जा 11, 1 जा 11, ओके। 11 इज डिविजिबल बाय 11, 11 1 जा 11, ओके। देन आफ्टर व्हाट वी विल डू, वी कैन फाइंड आउट द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दीज प्राइम नंबर्स। सो LCM of these three numbers, LCM of these three numbers will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 11, okay. LCM of 108, 132 and 144 will be is equal to product of these prime numbers. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 11. Now let us, we will find out product. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, 16 3 is 48, 48 into 3, now look here, 48 into 3, 144, 144 into 3, 3 4 is 12, carry over is 1, 14 3 is 42 plus 1, 43. Then after into 11, 2 1 2, 3 1 3, 4 1 4, 2 1 2, 3 1 3, 4 1 4, this is 2, 3 plus 2 5, 4 plus 3 7 and this is 4. So LCM is 4752, 2 2 is 4, 2 is 8, 2 is 16, 16 3 is 48, 48 3 is 144, 144 into 3, 432 into 11, it will give to you 4752, that means 4752, 4752 is LCM. LCM of the given number. My dear student, your next question is, this is question number 3. The thickness of a science book is 20 mm. Mm means millimeter. The thickness of a science book is 20 millimeter and depth of a mathematics book is 28 mm. mm means millimeter. Book of each type are stacked up in a separate pile. In this question we will find the minimum height of each pile. Find the minimum height of each pile such that both piles are of same height. In this question we will find out minimum height of each pile of the given book. So what we will do? Minimum. This question is depend on the LCM. That means minimum or lowest both are same. So we will find out what is the LCM. Minimum height of each pile of the book will be LCM of 20 mm and 28 mm. Now look here, this is 20 and this is 28. These two numbers are even number. Even number is divisible by 2. 10 2s are 20. 28 divisible by 2. It will give to you 14. Again, 10 is divisible by 2. 2 5s are 10. 14 is divisible by 2. 2 7s are 14. Again, and 5 is prime number, 7 is prime number. 5 is divisible by 5, it will give to you 1. 7 is not divisible by 5, so we can write as it is. Again, 7 is divisible by 7, it will give to you 1. So LCM of 20 and 28 will be, LCM of 20 and 28 will be, that means product of these prime numbers, 2 into 2 into 5 into 7, 2 2s are 4, 4 5s are 20, 27s are 140, 140 mm, 2 2s are 4, 4 5s are 20, 27s are 140. 140 mm, that means minimum height of each file of the book is 140 mm, means millimeter. So your required answer is 140 mm. This is the minimum height of each file of the book. My dear students, all these questions and basic point depend on your book. I hope that it will be very useful to you for your knowledge and upcoming exam. Thank you. God bless you.